Hello and welcome to In the Gardens. I'm horticulturist Greg Lusk. We're here at the Amarillo Botanical Gardens. Today we're going to talk about geraniums. It's that time of the year, one of our favorite time of the years, time to plant this year's bedding plants, and so here we go. The first thing we're going to talk about is geranium quality. You want to pick out geraniums that the foliage from top to bottom looks good. You don't want to have to clean up the geranium or have a bunch of yellow leaves. Don't just look at the flower. The flower is good for color now, but don't look at that to determine quality. And a whole bunch of flowers is not necessarily a good idea. Buds are fantastic, but those flowers are going to be gone. And if that was a poor quality plant, you're just going to have a poor quality plant for a while. So we're going to look at, see, there's no yellowing leaves. And if the plant's in great shape, no burnt edges, no holes. Just a good healthy plant. It's a young plant. The stems are green, not woody and brown, so that's another thing to look at. It's a young plant rather than old plants. Geraniums grow and bloom off of new wood. They bloom off of new wood. They don't bloom off the old wood, so you keep them growing to bloom. So the foliage looks great. Flowers nice as well. Then we're going to pop it out of the pot. The roots are white. If you pop it out of the plant and pot, do this at the nursery. And if the roots are dark or brown, put it back. It's not worth buying. It's been overwatered, kept too wet, and the roots are in bad shape. So good white roots, not too root bound, slightly. Geraniums have very fragile roots. I don't tear up their root ball because they just have very fragile roots and it doesn't do them much good. So this one's worth buying. These are all nice. As far as color, of course you can pick any color. They're all going to be great. Some great breeding work's been done. All the colors will perform exactly the same. However, you might consider about the time of day you enjoy your garden. If you pick, there's some really beautiful dark red geraniums out today. If you enjoy your garden in the evening after sundown or dusk, as soon as the sun goes down, that dark color is going to go away. It just disappears in the dark, and that's just the way it is. Whereas these lighter colors and even white, they'll still pop. You'll see them in low light. So early in the morning and late in the evening, when most of us are out, you know, before work, after work, we're in our yard, we're enjoying our yard, you want to be able to see that plant. So reconsider those dark geraniums. This scarlet red is a good choice because it's just enough brighter that it shows up. So next we're going to talk about the pot which we put the geraniums in. Of course you can put them right in the ground. They do very well in the ground. We'll talk about that a little bit more later. But the pot should be at least 12 inches. Anything smaller than that, it's just going to dry out too soon, too fast, and not enough nutrient holding capacity. The bigger the pot is, the larger amount of root ball there is, which less watering, more nutrients available, and just things grow better in a bigger pot. So this is a double wall plastic pot. It looks a nice looking pot. The double wall doesn't get so hot when the sun shines on, like a dark pot, single wall, it heats up really bad. Hot roots are a problem. They can cause retarded growth on the plants. Large clay pots in this area dry out quickly. They're beautiful. I like the clay pots. Concrete pots work really well also. They don't blow over and they usually have a pretty good size root volume. So we've selected the pot and the geraniums. Next is potting soil. Use a good quality potting soil. You can find this at any of our nurseries. It's Miracle-Gro. It's only slightly more than some of the junkier kinds that are just muck from a swamp somewhere. You'll know them. They're very heavy, very dark and sandy. They're just not very good. Miracle-Gro's my favorite because it's consistent and it just, things grow well in it. So we're gonna fill it up. The potting soil itself will settle once you water it. So we fill it up almost to the rim. We're gonna pop our plant out. This is a nice coral geranium. I really like it. Make a area here to put it in. And we're gonna plant it just slightly deeper than it's growing. That way the top of the roots are covered and it doesn't dry out quite as quickly that way. Next, now the Miracle-Gro says it's got 3 or 4 months of fertilizer in it. not so. It's going to wash out. So I'm going to do the slow release fertilizer. It's encapsulated fertilizer. It's pelleted. You can get it anywhere. I'm going to put it pretty generous, and I'm going to put this on the top. A couple hands full. The bigger the pot, the more. And then I'm just going to slightly kind of scratch it in, because as it breaks down and it's going to release over the entire summer, it's going to, the water's going to wash the nutrients into the soil. If you put it too low, the plant's going to miss a lot of it. So there, we got that. And then the next thing is, we're going to water it in, of course. Now here's one of my secrets. If you're just using plain water, water every couple days at first until it gets rooted a bit, then it's back off until you're doing it about two, maybe three times a week, depending on how much sun you get. Now, as far as sun goes, these geraniums do need sun. A half a day or more sun is good. East side is great. They'll grow right in the hot west sun, all day sun as well. They're very adaptable. They just don't like a lot of shade. They will grow and do some good in some shade, but it's got to be dappled shade, and they need some direct sun. So we got the plant potted and ready to go here. We're going to water it in. Now, I take and put a watering can in my yard, and every week I put a little, about half strength, water-soluble fertilizer. Any water-soluble fertilizer, that means it dilutes in water, it could be a powder or a liquid, that is for blooming plants, can be used. And then once a week, I give it a good drink. And notice, I'm going to water the leaves with the fertilizer. The fertilizer is absorbed through the leaves, and so therefore you get double action. You get the root fertilizer and you get the leaves, and they'll take advantage of that. That's a great secret. Once a week, your plants will grow and do good all summer. Next, we're going to talk about aftercare. Of course, geraniums flower, the flower fades, and it needs to be taken off. I see a lot of people doing this, taking the old flower and just snapping the head off it. Well, the problem with that is then this ugly stick dies, and it's just unsightly. So if you follow the blooming head down to the stem, it's got a breaking point. There's a joint there, and it breaks very easily right there. So that's the correct way to prune a geranium. The only other problem that geraniums usually have that you can really do much about is worms. Now, sometimes later in the summer, usually, they get a bud worm. It's a little worm. A little moth lays its egg right in the bud, and the little worm lives and eats the buds, and you'll realize that your geranium's making buds, but they're not opening, or they're turning brown when they're young. That's a bud worm. The easiest way to take care of that is a spray called BT. That's B as in boy, T as in Thomas. It's available at the nurseries. It's a biological. You can mix it up in a spritzer and just spray it on. What it does is it makes the worm sick and it dies. It's a stomach disease that only affects the worms that feed on the leaves. Well, all worms actually, but not earthworms, but caterpillars. So that's a good one. They're very little care. They're lots of enjoyment to geraniums. You take care of them like this, they'll last you all summer, and you'll hate it when it freezes in the fall and you have to decide whether to leave them out or bring them in. So thank you for joining us again today. So don't forget, this weekend, Saturday, April 29th, is Garden Fest. We open at 8:30 and we'll run until late afternoon. We're gonna have 35 vendors. There'll be all these great geraniums, these hanging baskets. Look at this petunia, springer eye, asparagus fern, mixed foliage baskets, and many more. Herbs, honey, strawberries, all kinds of fun gift items and art on display here to sell from local artists and vendors. That's Saturday, April 29th. We hope to see you here.